Welcome to Microsoft Project 2016 tutorials. In this video, I will show you how to add resources to the resource sheet, how to change the pay rate, and how to assign resources to tasks. Let's first create a resource pool. Enter the Task tab, click on the Gantt chart drop-down menu to access the resource sheet. Then we can enter resources that are available to us for this project. The resources can be people, materials, or equipment. For this project, there are only two types of people needed, software engineers and hardware engineers. We assign a group code such as SWE for software engineers and HWE for hardware engineers. Microsoft Project manages the resources in terms of percentages. This 100% means that there is one person available to work full-time on this project. If we have three software engineers available to work full-time, we would simply enter 300% here. Let's say for hardware engineers, we have one person available full-time, that is 100%, and another available half-time, that is 50%. When we group multiple resources together, these individuals are interchangeable. For example, all three software engineers are capable of doing the same type of work. There are no distinctions in terms of experience, ability, performance, or salary. If we want to recognize that some of the software engineers have more experience and a wider range of ability, it is best to simply enter their names separately. For example, Mary and Rachel. We will indicate that both of these are software engineers. Mary is available full-time, but Rachel is available half-time. When we assign resources in the future, we can assign Mary and Rachel to specific tasks or activities that we feel they would be best at. We can also differentiate them by setting a different pay rate for them. In order to show you how to enter pay rates for different types of resources, I have updated the resource pool and have now included two full-time marketing specialists and one part-time purchasing agent. I have also added a unit for testing the equipment. Note that I have updated the annual salary for the software and the hardware engineers. The default unit is an hourly rate. This can be easily changed by entering the annual rate here followed by YR for a year. The purchasing agents are paid by the hour at a rate of $60 per hour, and this will qualify them for an overtime rate of $90 per hour. We rent the testing equipment from someone else at the cost of $200 per hour, and there is a one-time use cost of $500, regardless of how much time we use the equipment. The accrual column shows a pay structure. Prorated means the cost is accrued on a day-to-day basis throughout the project. The other two options are that the resources are paid upfront or at the end once the work has been completed. We can also change the work calendar here. Standard is the default, and it means 8 hours per workday, 5 workdays per week. We can change this to a night shift, or we can change it to a 24-hour calendar if we need to. I've made some more changes in this resource sheet. I added a design team which consists of two full-time design engineers. I have also modified the cost of the testing equipment to $1,000 per day. A cost use fee of $500 will stay the same, but we don't have to pay for it until we return the equipment. Now let me show you how to assign resources to specific tasks. Let's go back to the entry table and our Gantt chart view. Now click on the Resource tab. We select the task and then click on the Resource Names column. We then click on the Assign Resources button. A window appears that lists all the resources in the resource pool. Let's say this task requires two design engineers and two marketing specialists in order to complete within the estimated duration. We will adjust the units first before we assign the resource. Since we need two design engineers, we click on the number of units. increase it to 200%, and then click on Assign. If we don't enter the units first and simply click on Assign, and then try to adjust the unit level, the cost will not be automatically updated. From here, we have to remove the resource, change the units, and then click Assign to get the correct cost. After we close this window, we want to make sure that we check the duration for this activity and make sure that it hasn't changed. This is because Microsoft Project assumes all tasks are effort-driven. So if it will take one person 7 days to complete a task, then it will take 4 people only a fraction of the time. Microsoft Project may automatically make this adjustment for you, and you will have to override this and return the duration to its original duration. Okay, that is how to add resources to the resource sheet, how to change the pay rate, and how to assign resources to tasks in Microsoft Project 2016. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. This is Yong Wang, and I'll see you in the next video.